Like most American families, the Chalfant family always got caught up in the hustle and bustle of the holidays. Christmas shopping, decorating, and last-minute baking. That changed in 2005, the year the family of four spent Christmas in Kazakhstan.
It was very much an adventure for the kids. They enjoyed everything. It did not matter that the conditions were like they were, and it was very unusual to us. The culture was very different.
Well, it's a different pace, no question. And I'm used to going 110 miles an hour and kind of a type A personality, but God wanted us to slow down that year for Christmas. It really allowed us to reflect on the true meaning of Christmas, and that's the birth of Jesus.
They only had enough room in their luggage to bring a few small presents. But Connor and Brooklyn, 8 and 9 years old at the time, didn't seem to mind. They were expecting the best gift of all. You see, the Chalfants had come to Kazakhstan to adopt a baby girl.
We got to go upstairs where all the babies lived, and we realized there's nothing we really need.
I came out of it feeling very blessed and that God had given us a lot and that I needed to be more thankful for the things that I had.
The highlight of each day in the small village was visiting the newest member of their family, baby Gazelle.
We went to the orphanage and had a chance to go there each and every day and spend time, met Gazelle the first day.
The third day they allowed us to go up to where she resided and we were able to pick her up from this area. And she saw us and she grinned and then she started laughing and then she started kicking her feet. So it was exciting for us to see that she was recognizing us after just a couple of days.
Baby Gazelle warmed up to her new family instantly, and Christmas held a special treat, their first family photo.
We had purchased a little red velvet dress for her. So on Christmas Day, we had our picture made by the Christmas tree.
So here we are in Christmas. As I say, in this 10 by 10 room, and we think that this is about adoption. And what we discovered was that was only a piece of God's puzzle. You know, the bigger piece was we were to reflect on the true meaning of what Christmas was. And we wouldn't have done that had we stayed in the United States.
The Chalfants returned home to Kentucky while the paperwork was processed. 4 weeks later, Matt and Tonya returned to Kazakhstan to bring baby Gazelle home for good.
She was clothed when they handed her to us when we went to pick her up, but they stood and waited for the clothing.
Right.
So we undressed her, and we knew to expect that, and we had clothes for her and a snowsuit to take her out of the orphanage in. And it was really sweet because there was nothing. She had nothing to take home. Just like they hand you your baby at the hospital once you've birthed the baby, they handed her to us and we had a little family picture and took a little video, and it was really sweet.
You know, even though you feel led of the Lord to do this, you still wonder what's that bonding process going to be with an adopted child. And when they hand you this baby and here's this little naked one-year-old, it is the exact experience that we had with our two biological children. God just flips the switch, and we were parents of a third child. You know, the interesting thing about adoption is you come into this and you think, we're gonna try to make a difference in this child's life. And what you realize is that it's not about the child, it's about you and what God wants to do in your heart and in our heart as a couple and in our family.
The family of five is doing great. Gazelle, now three, loves going to church and playing with her big sister. She giggles a lot and is loved by all. Christmas in Kazakhstan changed the lives of the Chalfant family forever. And Gazelle is a constant reminder of the real reason for Christmas.
Prior to the adoption, slowing down at Christmas had been on my prayer list for a very long time. Mm-hmm. How to simplify it and how to make it more peaceful. And it was something that I would start praying about way before Christmas season because I wanted it to be a meaningful circumstance. The adoption experience did give us that opportunity to step back and be still. And it's something we really appreciate.
While we celebrate Christmas, we should always think about the cross and really why he came. And we would have nothing to celebrate at Christmas without him dying on the cross. God can do amazing things with small people. There can always be miracles, no matter what.